Let's start with the good news here, right? Philae's talking back, which is good, but not everything went according to plan with this landing.
Right. The lander is in place, but there were several hiccups this morning, the most significant involving the harpoon system. Now, this comet is only 2.5 miles wide, so the force of gravity is actually quite weak. So in order to keep this lander on the surface of the comet, it needs to mount itself. It needs to latch on. And the harpoon system, which was supposed to facilitate that, did not deploy properly. Now, luckily, there were screws in the bottom of the legs of the lander, and that's what we believe is actually holding the lander in place right now.
Meaning that the screws actually were able to
drill through the surface of the comet and keep the lander in place so it didn't just bounce back into space.
Now, is that like a redundant system? Is that the idea?
Yes, and there was actually another system in place on the lander, which also did not work properly this morning. A thruster on top of the lander was supposed to help push back on the force once it landed so it didn't bounce back into space. That did not work properly this morning. So really, it was all dependent on these screws in the bottom of the legs, ultimately.
Amazing, Mark. And you look at that, I imagine, and you know so well the difficulties when it comes to space travel and really just everything working out as it's supposed to. How monumental is this? When you were watching this today, how big a deal is this?
It's a pretty big deal. And in space flight, doing these very hard things, it doesn't always go right. Even with space shuttle missions, we always have glitches along the way and we've got to overcome them. But when you look at what this team of people did at ESA and at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in California, it's quite incredible to fly a 10-year mission, have the spacecraft shut down for in excess of 30 months, to restart it, to rendezvous with something that's moving 40,000 miles an hour and then land on it. It's quite an incredible thing to do. And you got to give that ESA team and the NASA team a lot of credit for the success.